Well, after a slower week last week, things certainly have moved up a gear on the oil and gas front, and especially where the likes of Tullow Oil, Hurricane and Sound Energy are concerned. Well, Proactive's oil and gas commentator, Jamie Ashcroft, is with me on the line. Jamie, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon.
Jamie, let's kick off with Tullow then. Along with Cairn, they've reported successful wells. Bring us up to speed.
Yeah, so both Tullow and Cairn have in recent days, they updated their investors on recent successes, the wells that they've had in Kenya and separately offshore Senegal. Both cases, the oil companies, they're essentially proving up some scale here. They've each already made discoveries in these separate projects, and now they're amassing resources that, you know, will support what are starting to look like very big projects. So Tullow in Kenya and Cairn offshore Senegal, these respective campaigns continue. There's more drilling to come, so plenty for investors to keep looking at. But at some point, we'll also be looking for news on the corporate side of these projects, find out just how they're going to be paid for and how these developments fit into their bigger strategies. So, yeah, definitely one to watch for some of the bigger companies in the market.
And Sound Energy's been updating investors this week, Jamie, on one of their Morocco projects. What have they been saying?
Yeah, so obviously Sound's one that investors have been following closely. And this week they said that they've now got a rig on site at the Sidi Moktar project. That's also onshore Morocco, where they had success with Tendrara. Here, though, they're working over existing wells rather than drilling new ones. So the idea there is that they've identified two wells that they want to re-tap and rework. And if everything goes well there, they're hoping that they could be brought into production relatively soon. So it could be another value-adding program for Sound. It did perform particularly well with previous wells in Morocco. So there's going to be a lot of attention on this one. Continue to be anyway. And at the same time, they're still drilling in the sort of program in Italy. So that's another potential catalyst. So, yeah, it's still very much on investors' radar, Sound Energy.
88 Energy, another hot company, Jamie, with a strong following. What's the latest with them and Ice Wine 2?
Yeah, so that was 88 Energy is another favourite for investors last year, and they've got an exciting program underway over in Alaska, where they've potentially got a new shale play. As you mentioned, the Ice Wine 2 well, they said this week that drilling is completed there now. They're not really giving anything away at this point. They said the drilling phase is complete, and they're now going to carry out the logging work. In due course, they'll frack and test the well as well. So it's a production test eventually, and that will tell us everything that the investors are waiting for, everything that we need to know. So a few more weeks till we find out the important details, but clearly progress being made.
And finally, Jamie, Hurricane Energy, they've been in the headlines too. Remind us what they're up to.
Yes, so this is more of a corporate update, another finance update rather than well news. But the company confirmed this week that it brought in £12 million of new capital. They had a share warrants issue there just over a week ago. Those warrants were exercised and have since been sold to investors. It's a modest interim financing. It allows the company to commit to some long lead items, and while they kind of continue to talk about project financing for the much bigger project. Ultimately, we could see, I guess, a major deal, a major farm out deal, or a bigger, longer term financing deal. It looks like that's going to be a little way off just now. They've got this interim financing, so as one analyst put it, allows the company to keep their options open. What I think reflects well in this case, though, is that, you know, the company have been given the flexibility to manoeuvre. It's not necessarily the kind of luxury other companies might have had in a similar position. So, you know, I think that really reflects on the fact that they've had some big discoveries and some real good successes with recent wells, and they're plainly benefiting from that. All the while, there's investor interest, and so it's well supported. So, yeah, another one to watch, another company to look out for the next steps and the next news. So, yeah, all looking good.
Certainly another one to watch there, Jamie. Thanks very much for the update. Good to speak to you.
No problem at all.